Hello friends, welcome back to another episode of Engineering Today, and I hope you're all having a great time. As usual, Starbase is going through a lot of activities. A new drilling rig is getting ready for action near the launch site, specifically on the suborbital side. This could mean that the groundwork for the second orbital pad at Starbase is about to begin. The LR-11000, a heavy-duty crane, is being moved into place. Once the drilling rig is out of the way, there's a chance that Ship 30 could be rolled out onto Pad B for testing. The Malcolm drilling rig has been busy too, although it hasn't started drilling just yet. It's in the process of getting ready, doing visual preparations for the task ahead. Once it's fully operational, it's expected to kickstart the construction of the new orbital pad. Booster 13 is currently going through tests where it's exposed to extremely cold temperatures at SpaceX Massey's test site. This booster will be used for the sixth flight. The scene looked like it was snowing in Texas because of the frosty conditions during the testing. At the same time, the OLM work, or orbital launch mount work, has been finished. Marvin, a part of the testing equipment, is moving back to the test pad. Meanwhile, SpaceX's Starship 2 has got enthusiasts buzzing, especially the keen eye of the space engineer who broke down the design changes step by step. Let's look into the nitty-gritty of what's different and what it all means. First up, the forward flaps. They've been tweaked to be smaller with a 10-degree sweep, which matches Elon Musk's hint about improving re-entry with smaller flaps. Moving down, the tanks got stretched by about 1.82 meters. Now, the dual umbilical lines might seem like a small detail, but they make sense for orbital refueling, ensuring the ships dock belly-to-belly without any components getting in the way. Now onto the hostaging ring. The graphic shows a Soviet-style ring structure, but that wouldn't be stable or practical. The actual design might look different, but it's hard to say for sure. Inside the hostaging ring, there's a dome-like structure that seems a bit off. It wouldn't work as a blast surface without a deflector. At the base of the booster, the engine shielding has been removed thanks to the reliability of SpaceX's Raptor 3 engine. This will be an interesting experiment, seeing how the engines handle direct exposure to high-speed airflow. On the other hand, Elon Musk recently announced that the company is focusing on solving two key challenges to make space travel more feasible: making its Starship launch vehicle reusable and enabling it to refuel in space. Musk aims to achieve these goals by the end of next year, which he believes are crucial for establishing human life on other planets, like Mars. One major goal for SpaceX is to ensure that both the booster and the Starship can be reused multiple times. Reusability is vital because it helps reduce the costs associated with space travel. Musk has frequently emphasized the importance of making life multiplanetary, envisioning the creation of self-sustaining cities on Mars, and transporting people there using Starship. Another key technology SpaceX is working on is orbital refueling. This process involves filling the Starship's tanks with fuel while it's already in space. To accomplish this, SpaceX plans to send tanker versions of the Starship from Earth to meet up with the spacecraft. Musk explained that although orbital refueling is challenging, it's simpler compared to docking with the International Space Station. He likened it to docking with ourselves, indicating that it's an internal process rather than docking with an external structure like the ISS. SpaceX is planning to attempt a booster catch this year, which involves catching the booster with mechanical arms attached to a launch tower. Initially, the company will try to land the booster on a virtual tower during a test flight, followed by attempting to land it on a physical tower in subsequent flights. Musk estimates the chances of successfully catching the booster at 80 to 90% this year. Regarding the Starship spacecraft, SpaceX intends to perfect its landing capabilities before attempting to bring it back to the launch site. Musk stated that the spacecraft won't return until it can land a specific design twice at a particular location in the ocean. This cautious approach demonstrates SpaceX's commitment to ensuring the safety and reliability of its technology. Meanwhile, in the not-so-distant future, squads of American explorers are gearing up for a lunar adventure like no other. They're not your typical astronauts. These are cutting-edge robots armed with the latest technology, ready to explore the moon's ancient craters and pave the way for human colonization. These robotic pioneers, set to launch soon, have diverse roles. Some are 3D mapping experts, tasked with creating detailed maps of the lunar surface. Others are on a quest for the moon's most precious resource, water. And there are even prototypes in the works to establish a connection between the moon and Earth through an inter-world web. But why send robots instead of humans? Well, for starters, it's safer. These robotic scouts will lay the groundwork for future human missions, ensuring that when astronauts do arrive, they have everything they need to thrive. Back on Earth, a robotics revolution is driving the new era of lunar exploration. Advances in AI and global robotics networks are transforming the way we explore space. Soon, robots will be building launching pads, science labs, and habitats on the moon's south pole, setting the stage for human settlement. At the heart of this lunar renaissance is SpaceX's Starship. This colossal spacecraft, designed for planetary exploration and settlement, promises to revolutionize space travel. With its massive cargo capacity, Starship can transport people and equipment to the moon and beyond more efficiently than ever before. NASA's Artemis program, which aims to return astronauts to the moon, is set to utilize Starship as a lunar habitat and transportation system. Imagine a bustling lunar base powered by a fleet of starships shuttling between Earth and the moon. But it's not just about transporting humans. Starship's cavernous cargo hold can also carry scores of robots, ready to explore every corner of the moon's surface. These robots, equipped with advanced sensors and cameras, will help uncover the moon's age-old secrets. At the forefront of this exploration are researchers at institutions like Arizona State University, using data from orbiting satellites. They're building digital twins of potential landing sites, allowing astronauts to explore the lunar landscape virtually before setting foot on the surface. But it's not just about exploration, it's also about innovation. NASA's Jet Propulsion Lab is developing a swarm of super-intelligent robots called Cadre bots. These robots, equipped with stereo cameras and mesh radio networks, will create photorealistic 3D maps of the lunar terrain. What's truly groundbreaking is how these robots operate. Mission controllers on Earth provide broad guidelines, and the robots collaborate to decide the best course of action. In a unique experiment in robotic democracy, they even elect a leader every hour to lead the expedition. This new era of lunar exploration holds immense promise. From mapping the lunar surface to establishing human settlements, robots are leading the way into a future where the moon is not just a destination, but a new frontier for humanity to explore and inhabit. And that's all for now.
Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting. And kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.